Start off on a rather sad note today, and that is the passing of Edward Charles Whitey Ford, a child of the city, born in Manhattan, grew up in Astoria, Queens. He passes away at the age of 91, surrounded by his family. What a career, what a life for Whitey Ford. Listen, I'm not young enough, I'm not old enough to have really remembered him pitching. But just look at the numbers. They're amazing. 236 wins, 106 losses. He has the highest winning percentage. I believe it's 690 of any pitcher in the 20th century. He dominated in the World Series. He won six World Series titles. He had three World Series shutouts. He was a 10-time All-Star. My personal interaction with Whitey Ford was always delightful. He was a mischievous guy. He always had a sparkle in his eye, a twinkle. He enjoyed life. He was someone that just knew how to live. Let's put it that way. He and Mickey and Billy, well, they're together again, along with Yogi. They have a great battery up there now, and it's sad, but what a great life he did lead. He was born Edward Charles, and he became Whitey in 1949 when he was playing for Binghamton in the Yankee farm system, and his manager was Lefty Gomez. And Lefty Gomez just called him Whitey because of his blonde hair, and it stuck, and he's been Whitey Ford ever since. The times that I'd see him at Old Timers Day, he was always the center of the action, always quick with a quip. You could see how close he and Mickey and Billy were when they were together. There was an unspoken language among the three of them. Just an amazing life, and obviously a very full life. He passes away at the age of 91, but it's sad. It really is sad that another icon passes. If you look at the Hall of Famers that have left us in this insidious year of 2020, Al Kaline, Lou Brock, Tom Seaver, Bob Gibson, and now Whitey Ford as well. And Whitey Ford joining the Yankees in 1950 at the age of 21, and just had a great run for the Yankees as they were trying to win the American League pennant. It was the second to last year of Joe DiMaggio's career. He retired the next season, and he became the youngest Yankee pitcher ever to start a World Series game in game four against the Phillies in 1950. And he was pitching 8 2/3 shutout innings for 21-year-old kid in the World Series. And then a fly ball got caught in the sun and was dropped by Gene Woodling, who was a really good outfielder. And that allowed two unearned runs to score and stopped Whitey from getting a shutout, stopped Whitey from getting a complete game at the age of 21 to close out a World Series against the Whiz Kids. And Casey Stengel came out and took him out of the game and brought in Allie Reynolds to get the final out of the game. And the crowd was booing, and Whitey Ford said, "I couldn't believe they were booing. I mean, Gene Woodling dropped the ball. I thought I did okay." But then it came to his realization that it was Casey Stengel they were booing, and he laughed. He said, "I had left 60 tickets for my family and friends from Astoria. I think a lot of the booing came from there, that Casey actually did take me out." But what a wonderful, wonderful life. We extend our condolences to his family, his son Edward. It just seems one day after the next, we just get bad news, yeah. Either in sports or out of sports. Eddie Van Halen, Seaver, Gibson, Brock, and on it goes. And today it's Whitey Ford. So again, everybody from the YES Network, everybody from ESPN, we send our condolences to the Ford family for a great American life and a life well lived. He certainly enjoyed every minute that he spent on this planet. That's for sure.